Good morning. You're watching Fox 46. Good day, Charlotte.
Hey, coming up, ear infections are very common this time of year. We got Dr. Temple here saying, parents, listen up. Your child may not need an antibiotic. She's got some interesting remedies. Stay with us. Here we go. Fox 46 is getting results for your health this morning. So we all know this time of year, about 30 million visits to the pediatrician. It's for ear infections. Ear infections are the most common childhood illness treated by antibiotics. But did you know that 80% of them don't actually need antibiotics? We're talking about kids. So parents, what do you do? Dr. Anna Maria Temple is here with some unusual, interesting ideas, some alternatives. Always a pleasure to have you with us, Dr. Temple. Oh, wow. So let's start with the ear infection. Yes. What is it? What's going on when a kid has that?
A lot of times it starts with a cold. A virus comes in, a cold, the kid gets full of snot, and then it backs up into the ears. Okay. And then it causes a lot of pain and fever, and then everyone runs to the doctor, and they see pus in the canal, behind the eardrum, and then everyone expects antibiotics.
Right. That's what we've just kind of grown up assuming that was the treatment.
Correct. But what we're finding is that with each round of antibiotics, it makes you more at risk for having more antibiotics. Oh. And in fact, children who get one round are more likely to then see a surgeon for tubes. And the more antibiotics we have, the more other issues we're going to develop, like inflammatory bowel disease, asthma, eczema. So it's not just a quick fix, because a lot of parents, the kids are sick, they want a quick fix so we can all go to work, all go to school, right?
Yeah.
But it ends up being this really long, drawn out chronic issue.
Ooh, that's not good. Okay, so you got some alternatives, some things that we can do to help treat an ear infection. Where do you want to start?
So first, we're going to talk about the snot. We have got to take care of the snot, because that's the first problem.
Okay.
And we can do some saline spray, which a lot of people know. Mm-hmm. What a lot of people don't know is that colloidal silver actually has been shown in clinical studies in children to help with their sinus infection and reduce the risk of ear infections.
What is that called?
Colloidal silver.
Are those drops? Do you put them in your mouth?
These are the ones you put in mouth. You can put these in saline spray. You can make nose spray, and it comes in a nose spray as well.
Okay.
And after you do those things, you've got to remove the snot.
Oh, dear Lord.
And this is the most disgusting thing of all time.
Is that a suction tube for your nose?
Totally. You put this in the kid's nose, and you put this in your mouth, and you suction
through it. No.
You want to try?
No, I don't want to try it. So this basically goes up in my nose?
Mm-hmm.
There's got to be something in here to prevent it. I mean, obviously the fear is the obvious here.
Right, so there's a filter in there.
Oh my gosh, it's like a nose vacuum.
Exactly what it is. But it works amazing. You just got to get over the mental thing that you're sucking your kids' boogers into your mouth.
Have you used that?
No, it came out after my kids were too big.
Uh-huh, of course. Great timing, Dr. Temple. Okay. Okay, there's one solution. Clear out the sinuses.
Yes.
All right, what else?
All right, and then we have supplements.
Okay.
And in the supplement category, elderberry syrup, which is here, this one is local. You cannot give this to kids under the age of one because it's got raw honey. But we can do vitamin C, zinc, and probiotics.
These are to help prevent getting sick, which then could lead to the ear
infection.
Correct,
but you can also use them when you're getting sick because it powers up the immune system and helps you get over the ear infections.
And these are all safe and good for kids.
That's right.
Okay, good to know.
And then we have essential oils, which are the thing going on.
But
a lot of people don't know how to use them. We do not want to take essential oils and drop them in kids' ears. You never put stuff in the ear.
Okay.
Right. But you can use them diluted, and you can do massages. You can actually put them on cotton balls and put them on the outside of the ear. Studies were done in animal models where it cures ear infections in animals when you do this. But we also have a lot of information that these are antibacterial, antiviral. These three specifically work for ear infections.
That's really interesting. Okay, and then we've got, are these dairy alternatives? What does dairy have to do with ear infections and sickness?
You know what? Grandmas all over the world are so excited because they were right. When you're drinking, when you have full of snot and congestion and you're eating dairy, it does, in some kids, makes it thicker and it can lead you to backing up and having ear infections.
Whoa.
This is, if you want to prevent ear infections, your kid has had a lot of ear infections and you don't know what to do. The first thing, well, sugar, we know, we've just discussed before.
We have.
So sugar reduction and getting rid of dairy, using dairy alternatives, including milk, cheese, yogurt, and ice cream.
All will cut down on the mucus production.
Correct.
Interesting. Does there seem to be a kid's favorite as far as flavors? Because you got soy, rice, almond, oat. I mean, you got all these alternatives.
I'll tell you, and if you get soy milk, it always has to be organic. No exceptions, because soy is the most polluted crop we have.
Oh, my gosh.
In the States.
Okay. So get it organic if you go soy.
And the only ingredients in it should be water and soybeans.
That's
no
it.
Other
Nothing other than
exactly.
those two.
And it's very creamy. So the kids really like that one the best.
Cut down on the dairy and maybe get a nose vacuum.
A nose vacuum.
Two of the highlights from this today.
Yes, yeah.
Dr. Temple, always, thank you so much. Appreciate
thank
it.
You
We're
so going
to take a quick break. We'll be back with more after this.